The Bill of Rights and Selective Incorporation. In the beginning, the Bill of Rights only restricted the federal government or Congress, not the states. So states did not have to follow the Bill of Rights, freedom of speech, freedom of religion, and so on. Selective incorporation is an extremely important concept for everybody to learn. So most states had already developed a Bill of Rights with similar provisions, but states did not have, not originally have to follow the National Bill of Rights. It was understood that the federal constitution referred only to federal laws, not state laws or court rulings. So this idea of selective incorporation is the process by which the Supreme Court ruled that in landmark cases that state laws must also adhere to selective Bill of Rights provisions through the 14th Amendment Due Process Clause. The Supreme Court used the 14th Amendment Due Process Clause to require the states to guarantee their rights, and actually these are important ones. So it's like the freedom of speech should not only be for the federal government, but it should also apply to the state government. Freedom of press, freedom of religion, these main things are basically so important, so inherent to us, that not only should the federal government not be allowed to restrict these rights, but nor should the state or local governments. Now, obviously, your business can, corporations can, school district can, but the idea is that the federal government can't, and that's in the Bill of Rights. But with this selective incorporation, one at a time, in certain areas, in certain spots, it's not all at once, but gradually we have incorporated the Bill of Rights to basically apply to the states and not just the federal government.